On our YouTube channel, we actually have a lot of how-to videos that are pretty professional and they show you guys a lot of things. But in this video, I actually wanted to do something fun. So I've had this RC car on my desk for a while now, and I actually am going to try to control this with my Trueform waveform generator. So the reason I'm using the Trueform generator is there are some really cool features in that that are going to allow me to control this a lot better than with some of the other generators that are out there. So that includes like AM modulation with two different channels, arbitrary waveform generation, arbitrary waveform sequencing, and then finally USB drag and drop to get some files onto the generator. So let's go ahead and start off by trying to figure out how to simulate the signals that are coming out of this remote in order to control this car. I'm over here at my oscilloscope, and I've taken apart the remote control to get access to the control lines. And all I'm going to do right now is I'm going to press the backwards button try to capture that signal. Go ahead and press stop. And it turns out that this particular remote control actually has a 45 megahertz clock in there, so that's the carrier frequency that we're going to be using at. But looking at the scope capture, it actually looks like we're using amplitude modulation in order to control the car. So since I was pressing the backwards button, the control signals for the backwards is actually just four control pulses. These pulses are about 2 milliseconds in width and 75% duty cycle. And then there are a number of 1 millisecond pulses. It actually, if you look it up, the number of pulses after the control pulse determines the direction of the car. So since I was pressing backwards, it actually turns out that 10 pulses after this control signal is going to tell the car to go backwards. If I wanted to go forward, we'd have 40 different pulses. Forward right would have, I think, 46 different pulses, and so on and so on. So the number of pulses is going to determine the direction that this is going to go. So since it is an amplitude modulation signal only, I can do that pretty easily with my function generator. So let's go ahead and do that with my function generator. I'm ready to simulate my signal with my function generator, with my 33600, a Trueform series waveform generator. The signal that we saw on the scope was actually an AM modulated signal. So to create that modulation pattern, I've created an arbitrary waveform, which has four 2 millisecond pulses for that control signal, and then the 10 1 millisecond pulses for the backwards signal. So that'll be modulating my channel 2. So channel 2, I'm going to set up to be my carrier, and let's set up the amplitude to be 10 volts peak to peak, maximum output, and the frequency will be 45 megahertz, which you'll remember was the carrier frequency of this guy. And then to turn on modulation, I'm just going to press modulate and use the source to be channel 1 and turn modulation on. So that's it. So let's give it a try out and make sure that we actually can make this car go backwards. Oh, I forgot to mention I also have this antenna to convert my power into something that is transmittable. Let's go ahead and turn on channel 1 and watch it go backwards. So, success. But that's not really quite all that interesting. So let's go into arbitrary waveform sequencing and actually make this car go left, right, and forward and backwards and do a few different things. So let's go ahead and do that. So now I wanted to create a sequence so I can actually make this car go backwards and forwards a little bit and have some turns. What I have here is Waveform Builder Pro, and there are the four different patterns for generating for going different directions. Right now I've got forward for a few seconds, taking a right turn forward, and then going backwards for a little bit, and then going backwards right for a little bit as well. So we'll see how it goes. If you want a little bit more information about sequencing, we do have another video, which we'll put down on the link on the bottom of this video, and you can check that out. But let's go ahead and send this data to the instrument and press send. Okay. So I haven't actually touched any settings on my generator. So all I'm going to do is turn on the output. Let's move this laptop out of the way so it doesn't get run over. And turn on the output and actually see if this does anything interesting. Put it local first. I guess it falls out a little bit. So you can see it kind of going backwards and forwards in a little bit. So I'm going to play around with that a little bit more, try to maybe do an obstacle course or something a little bit later. But hopefully with this video, you can see some of the benefits of Trueform waveform generators, as well as us having a little bit of fun here at work. So thanks a lot, and I'm going to go play a little bit more. Thanks.